You guys are good. Two carols in one. What a great way to start. Well, our next festive favourite, number 8 in the top 10, was written in 1848 by Cecil Francis Alexander. For more than 90 years, it's been the carol that a solo chorister sings in King's College, Cambridge, to begin the festival of 9 lessons and carols. It is, of course, Once in Royal David's City. Well, to sing it for us tonight, a class act who shot to fame on Britain's Got Talent. They've been together since they sang in church for their teacher's wedding ceremony. Ladies and gentlemen, boys and girls, please welcome Jonathan and Charlotte.
Thank you.
wonderful. Jonathan and Charlotte, ladies and gentlemen. Well done, both of you. Now then, at number seven, our next Christmas carol for all of us to sing is a powerful anthem for peace written by Edmund Sears in 1849. Sears wanted humanity to hush the noise and to live in peace with one another. What a great message, not just for Christmas, but for all the year round. Magnificent, just beautiful. Now then, on Christmas Eve, nearly 150 years ago, Phillips Brooks stood in a field in Bethlehem, surveying the scene close to the spot where Jesus was born. He was so inspired that he wrote our next carol for the children of his Sunday school to sing. Performing a carol that just had to be in the top 10, it's our number 6. Please welcome our star guest, the lovely Hayley Westnerer.
Oh.
Ladies and gentlemen, Hayley Westmorah. Well, can you believe we're almost halfway through our countdown of the UK's top 10 carols? Are you enjoying yourselves?
Yes.
Hope you are at home too. You might be surprised this next one isn't the most popular of all. It's so widely sung at carol services, especially on Christmas Day. It's certainly a favourite for many of us, so do sing along, especially in the chorus. It is, O Come, All Ye Faithful. Magnificent singing, well done. I'm delighted to introduce our next choir. When they're not at school or singing at parish church services, they're travelling the world and delighting audiences with their unique sound to sing their beautiful interpretation of Silent Night, my favourite boy band. Please welcome Libra. Libra, ladies and gentlemen. What a sound. Well, we've reached the top three carols. How exciting. And number three is a carol that combines the talents of two giants when it comes to wonderful words and marvellous music. In the last century, verses penned by prolific hymn writer Charles Wesley and music composed by Felix Mendelssohn were brought together to produce a timeless classic. Let's sing. Hark, the herald angels sing. I can feel the excitement building as we're down to the final two carols, ladies and gentlemen. And number two, a carol written by Christina Rossetti. Her beautiful words are linked with music by both Gustav Holst and Harold Dark. Singing the Holst version of In the Bleak Midwinter, please welcome to the big sing stage, the amazing Susan Boyle.
What a love.
How did you feel singing it in this building?
It felt really exciting. I'm very exhilarated. It's my first time here.
Is it your first performance in the Royal Albert Hall?
My very first time.
What does Christmas mean to you?
Christmas means being with the family, being with friends, and celebrating it in a holy and harmonious fashion.
The church has always played a massive part in your life, hasn't it?
It's been a very central part of my life.
In what way?
I feel it's a special place of worship, and that you're actually communicating with God.
Do you feel that when you're on stage like this, that you're communicating with God in a way as well?
Very much so. I feel that very much so here, right now.
We all know about your journey. It's been incredible. It really, really has. Apart from being here for the very first time, what have been some of the highlights for you?
Travelling the world, making my albums, completing my very first concert tour, which I intend to do more of next year, and really having a ball.
Ladies and gentlemen, give her a round of applause. Susan Boyle. Right, this is it. The time has come. We're ready to reveal which carol most people voted for as their favourite. As it happens, it's not sung often in church services by a congregation. We often hear it sung by a soloist or choir. And have we got a very special soloist to sing it? Star of many a stage musical, he presents his own show on Radio 2, and he's lovely too. Please put your hands together for Michael Ball! Happy Christmas.
And you.
It's a silly question, but how much do you love Christmas?
It's a fantastic time of year. It's a time that we look back on our lives as well. It's a time to reflect and think about people that we miss and we haven't seen for a while, and think about all the wonderful experiences we've had at this time of year. I love it. I absolutely love it.
Is it always a time of warbling for you, or are you up with your feet in front of the fire?
Every day is a time of warbling for me. I try not to work, actually, too much over Christmas and get away with the family and spend time doing that. But, you know, in this business, sometimes you have to. Sometimes you have to work over Christmas.
You've sung all over the world, all kinds of music, from musical theatre to pop, you name it, you've done the lot. What's it feel like that you're singing the nation's favourite carol?
It's the biggest thrill, also to sing it here in probably my favourite place to sing, and it is also my favourite carol.
Oh, it is?
Absolutely. It's the one I voted for. I love it.
Do you think we should let them know what it is?
Absolutely.
What's the number one carol, Michael?
It's O Holy Night. Yeah. Beautiful.
Why do you think it's so special? You must have sung it millions of times.
I have sung it a lot. I think it's because it's not particularly traditional. There's a drama to it. There's a thrill to the lyric. It's about expectation. It's about feeling tiny because something so enormous is going on. It's beautiful, and it's got a wonderful melody.
You look very smart, so you're here. Will you sing it for us?
You bet. Try and stop me.
Hey, good. Michael Ball, ladies and gentlemen.
Cheers, Alan.
Now then, as Michael gets ready to sing it, thank you for joining us. I hope you've enjoyed singing along to the UK's top 10 carols. You can check out the full list on the Songs of Praise website if you fancy. So from myself and all of us here, have a very happy and peaceful Christmas.
The stars are brightly shining. It is the night of our dear Savior's birth. Long lay the world in sin and error pining, till he appeared and the soul felt its worth. The thrill of hope, the weary soul rejoices, for yonder breaks a new and glorious dawn. Christ was born.